Hey guys, it's Indigo. Today's video, I'm going to be unboxing a couple of loot crates. They've been piling up again, so I'm gonna get to it today. As you might notice, the wind is howling outside, and I have vents above my stove. Those are kind of clattering, and I can't really do much about it besides wait for summer, so. But I've noticed in some other videos, people have said that they actually like the windy noises, so let's just get to it. Quite a big pile. Three loot crates. And I'm gonna go through all of them. At least that's the plan. And I have no idea which ones they are. But let's face it, we're here to relax. Open them and grab the items out. This is definitely one of the older ones. And I have to admit, I did peek because it's been so long ago, but I barely really remember exactly what's inside. This item I do remember. Brown, Back to the Future, Funko Pop. As you might know, I do collect Funko Pops. And I'm also gonna have to give a fair warning. If there's anything in the box that is green, it's gonna mess up the green screen. Really cool. I used to love Back to the Future as a child. And this one is pretty special. It's a Lootcrate exclusive. So this will go nicely with the rest of my collection. That was a t-shirt. And I have to admit, I have no clue where the shirt is from exactly, but I think it's some sort of movie that I kind of missed out on. But it's a pretty nice shirt. I love the color. And as always, I love sounds. Here we have the hoverboard. that we were promised. I have a feeling this screen here is gonna definitely mess up, but okay. This document certifies this 1-to-5 scale replica of the Back to the Future 2 hoverboard. It was created by Quantum Mechanics Incorporations under license from Universal Pictures exclusively for Lootcrate. Pretty cool. It's in some sort of mirror. I like it. I think the theme of this Lootcrate was time. We have another time-related item. I'm probably going to offend a lot of people by saying that I never watched Doctor Who, and I think it's pretty uninteresting. I've tried some episodes, but it couldn't really catch me. Be a pretty good show. The item, however, is pretty cool, and I might actually use it. Sonic screwdriver spork. I think this is pretty funny. I've actually never owned a spork. Well, it'll be pretty interesting to see how it works in practice. I kinda like it. Then we have the magazine, which indeed is called Time, the theme that is. I sort of strange Doctor Who quiz slash flowchart. Back to the Future, Dr. Emmett Brown, Final Figure. Exclusive Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure t-shirt. Exclusive Back to the Future Part 2, Hoverboard Replica. Exclusive Doctor Who Spork Utensil. And the Time Button. This one has a lot of coca, isn't it? It has a pair of sunglasses with a helmet on it, which is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles themed. Which is actually the second pair of sunglasses that looking weird is not that bad. This item I have opened because I couldn't possibly resist. It's a random Blizzard figure. You can see some of the options or possibilities. You have Kerrigan, Arthas, Sylvanas, Seth Zeratul, Murky, Diablo, Mystery Figure, Mystery Figure, Mystery Figure. And I really hoped I would get Sylvanas. Sylvanas is my absolute favorite, and I am 100% obsessed with her character. She is the queen, the banshee queen of the Forsaken or Undead, which are a playable race and faction in the World of Warcraft. And I need to stop myself before I give you a retelling of Sylvanas' entire life, because I'm that obsessed. But the one that I got is also really cool. The one that I got is from StarCraft. Now it's impossible to do without loudness, but here we have my little angry Kerrigan figure. And Kerrigan is really cool. Even though I've never fully played all of the games, I've heard a lot about her lore and story. And she has tentacles for hair. Next up is another winner. A Vault Boy bobblehead. Do I even need to explain? Fallout is one of my favorite game franchises. Blocked the poor guy's face. Oh my gosh. I don't know exactly what material this is made of, but it smells divine. Moving on. Premature like that. If you don't know about Fallout, then go play it. But bobbleheads are a very important item in the game. You can collect them, and they give you a variety of stat buffs. They've been made into merchandise a lot, but I've never owned one before, so I'm really stoked. This guy is really cool. He's got the full 111 jumpsuit. This little face says Vault Tech, because in the game these Vault Boys are produced by Vault Tech. And another exciting item. Holding it upside down, classic. It's a Hunger Games Mockingjay pin. And Hunger Games is one of my favorite book series. I think it was really interesting, and I loved the dystopian future thematic. I'm also a big fan of Battle Royale, so really aligned with my interest. You probably notice how tired I look. I'm still a bit sick, so I'm feeling a lot better than I was. Still not 100%. Not sure what exactly this is made of. I want to say metal. It is cold, like metal. I had a bit of a fight getting this little one out, but don't worry. I have tamed the foul creature. The fearsome beast. And I have hair everywhere. I'm sorry. I think this is really awesome, and it'll go nicely on my jacket. But for this video, purposes, I guess I can pin it to my vest. Next is my 3-month membership pass, which I don't already have like 20 of, so. But I recently resubbed under my own account. I don't know exactly what this is. It's a gift tag thingy. That's cute. Here we have the magazine with some really cool. And this one is called Combat. It's great. One thing that we've missed, so I'll skip that. But we have the exclusive Fallout 4 Vault Boy Bubblehead, TMNT Shredder Sunglasses, The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 2 Pin. Something else that I missed. Cute but Deadly Final Vigor. Show you all the figures, which are really cool. They're so adorable, and I want them all, even though they're super expensive. Now, let's look at the rest. Isn't this amazing? Some more cute but deadly stuff. Diablo and Daryl, I think, even though I've never really played Diablo much. Illidan. They're magnets, actually. Really cool. I'll be putting these up on my fridge for sure. I like these a lot. I love magnets to go on my fridge. It's kind of filled. Maybe one day I'll share. Maybe one day I will film my fridge for you, and you can hear all the god-awful noises it makes all the time when I'm filming, and how much it annoys me. And it's gonna be extremely tingly, whether you like it or not. Here we have. Street Fighter comic, and I do apologize, but I just didn't really grow up with Street Fighter. But I'm sure there's plenty of folk that would be pretty stoked about this. The inside of this box is some sort of thing you can put together, which I might do for shits and giggles after this, because it looks pretty cool. This one is heavy. one that's very... like I'm looking at it with this disgusted face. Like, ew. But I think it's pretty sci-fi. Christmas, ugly Christmas sweater themed t-shirt. Is this Star Wars themed? I don't know. You can tell me anything about Star Wars and I'll believe it because I've never really been into it. I've always been more of a Star Trek. I love how with opening these geek loot crates and stuff like that, I show my true colors as a fake nerd. At least I still have some credit as a vampire nerd. So I've got that going for me, which is nice. Just being silly. It's a cool shirt though. I'll give him that. The rest of this is in a halo, I guess like an ammo crate. And I've never been into Halo that much. I've played it a couple of times with friends, but I do like the idea of an ammo box. Smells really weird. You know those machines where you put in a coin and you get like a capsule? Like a capsule toy. Kind of smells like that. I don't know why. I look so tired. I'm so sorry. Wait, I shouldn't say sorry. I'm sorry for saying sorry. Few things in here. First, we've got a Galaxy Quest emblem patch, and this is way, way over my time. But I do know about it, to my credit. This document certifies this prop replica of the Galaxy Quest emblem patch was created by Quantum Mechanics Incorporations under license from Paramount Pictures exclusively for Lootcrate. I like this thing. It's cool. Another Funko Pop. This time it's a Star Wars Funko Pop. Han Solo in his snow gear. Now, I do like this pop, but I haven't seen the damn movie. So I'm sure someone else would appreciate it more, but it's cool. You see some of the others have available in this particular wave. And this is the new R2-D2, right? I think it's called like BB-80 or something. I don't know. Something like that. I've seen it on the internet. And, I mean, it's socks. I'm never gonna say no to socks. And I guess they're pretty adorable. Smell like socks though. I look like such a junkie sniffing merchandise. They're cute though. They're very soft. And here we have the Galaxy pin, and this was the December crate, I think. Yeah. And that was everything that was in the ammo box, but there's more. Some sort of halo thing. I'll have to get this to someone, actually, please. And then the magazine. Exclusive Star Wars Han Solo vinyl bobblehead. Exclusive ugly holiday sweater t-shirt. And let's see. It's not a Star Wars thing. I'm sorry. I can safely wear it because it's just a cool space thing. Without being called. Exclusive Galaxy Quest.